happy Wednesday. Before we get started, please rise for your pledge. LMS, it's Julia with your school news for today. Today is day 5, Wednesday, December 14th, and these are your student announcements. Everyone looks great in all your colors, jerseys, and causes. Remember that tomorrow is sweatshirt day. Good luck to our choruses at tonight's winter concert. Want to hear some great holiday music? Come on out at 7 p.m. Admission is free. Chorus members are reminded that report time is 6 p.m. Candy Cane Grams sales start today. Student Council members will be taking orders for candy grams during lunch today through Friday. There's an informational meeting for anyone interested in auditioning for this year's spring musical Tuesday after school until 4 p.m. Any 8th grader interested in applying to be a stage manager for the spring musical needs to pick up, complete, and return an application form to Mr. Campbell in room 408 by next Wednesday. The LMMS used book sale runs through next Wednesday. All books are $1 and all proceeds benefit the LMMS Angel Network. Now before we head on over to your world news, here's a special holiday musical treat featuring some of your musical teachers.
Is Abby with your world news for today. Freshman point guard Hansel Emanuel of Northwestern State got extra applause on December 10th for making his first points for the team since he only has one arm. The college ended up winning the game against Louisiana Monroe 91-73. Last year, ESPN was already reporting to officials about Emanuel and his journey. Emanuel was only 6 when a cinder block wall collapsed under him, causing him to need to amputate his arm. His father, who was a professional player in the Dominican Republic, posted videos of his son playing basketball, which caught the attention of one of his former teammates. His former teammate is the head coach at Life Christian Academy in Florida. Hansel Emanuel gained a scholarship and won the state championship in January 2021. Now, 23 months later, Emmanuel is still going with his basketball journey. This past Saturday, he was 2 of 3 from the field and 1 of 5 from the foul line, along with 2 rebounds in only 8 minutes. After his score, he said, "I know my family was proud. I had to keep working. You can't give up." Now on over to your weather news.
Hey Ole Miss, it's Harry back at it with your weather for today. Today's high is going to be 38 with a low of 23, and it's going to be partly cloudy. Tomorrow's going to have a high of 39 and a low of 25, and it's going to be raining or snowing throughout the day. Ole Miss, why can't we always tell where Santa's around? You can always sense his presence. Now on over to your sports update.
Hey Ole Miss, it's Julia with your sports news for today. In the 2022 World Cup, on Saturday, France beat England 2-1. This sent France directly into the semifinals against Morocco, which will occur today. Yesterday afternoon, as many of you may have watched, Argentina defeated Croatia 3-0. This means that whoever wins the France-Morocco game will play Argentina in the finals. Moving back to United States sports, the Philadelphia Eagles defeated the New York Giants on Sunday 48-22. This gave the Eagles a free pass into the playoffs, clinching their spot. The New York Giants began their season extremely strong with a 6-1 record. In the past 6 games, they have gone 1-4-1, making them fall to the number 4 spot in the NFC East Division. What do you think about this, Ole Miss? Who are you rooting for in the World Cup semifinals and final? That's all for me. Now on over to Juliana with your entertainment news for today.
Good morning, Ole Miss. It's Juliana with your entertainment news for today. Director and writer Todd Phillips shared the first look of Joaquin Phoenix as the Crown Prince of Crime for the upcoming Joker sequel. Philip showed the image of Phoenix as the movie's anti-hero Arthur Fleck in an Instagram post over the weekend. The 48-year-old previously won an Academy Award for Best Actor in 2020 for his leading performance in The Joker. The Joker was a commercial success with a box office run of view that exceeded over $1 billion, making it the highest grossing rated R film. It has been confirmed that Lady Gaga will feature in this movie. She announced in August that she'll be in the movie, which is set for an October 2024 release date, but she did not confirm what role she will play. Many fans have guessed that Lady Gaga will play Joker's sidekick, Harley Quinn, but none of the film's producers have confirmed this. So, Ole Miss, do you plan to watch this movie once it comes out? That's all from me, and now let's head on over to your segment.
I need to find my toothbrush. I'm gonna pick one up when I go out today. Other than that, I'm in good shape.
What movie is that from?
Turkey, get your Christmas turkey. Hey, look, we're gonna pop there, Martin.
It's a boomerang fish. Oh, guaranteed fresh.
Obviously. Stop.
I'm gonna give them a bit. What's that?
Children, back to your seats. The snow can wait.
Is Frosty the Snowman?
It's Home Alone.
Frosty the Snowman.
Frosty. It's not Frosty the Snowman.
Santa Claus.
Okay, people, tomorrow morning, 10 a.m., Santa's coming to town.
Santa! Oh, my God!
That's all for your Buzz TV, and have a great rest of your day, everyone.